And today I want to talk about Cacia's Tranquil Chamomile Aromatherapy Mineral Bath. I'm going to tell you guys a little bit about Cacia, the company, then I'm going to talk about the product itself. Finally, I'm going to give you my opinion of it. My name is Sharon. Welcome back to my channel. Make sure you guys subscribe below and turn on notifications to get the latest updates. Okay, so let's get started. Cacia is part of Frontier. And they are a co-op. So Cacia started in 1982, and then in 1993, they joined with Frontier. And Frontier embodies many things that I like. So they focus on sustainability. They're also focused on the small grower community, or small farms and organizations. They do say that they try to educate their customers, tell them about aromatherapy, and they also like to share information. They also have a charitable project that they focus on. You can see this on their website. It's called the Positive Change Project, and it focuses on the health and education of women and young girls. So I do really like the company and everything that they embody. I don't have many products from them. I know that you can find them in a lot of natural or health food stores, so they are very easily accessible. You can also purchase them from Amazon as well as online on their website. So I got this and I opened it, so I apologize that it's kind of all watery, but I did use it, so it's kind of water stained. I've used it a little bit, and they have the information on the back. So what they have here, on the front here, they say they have Roman chamomile, lavender, and patchouli. And I hate all three of these. So Roman chamomile, I'm not a big fan of it. It's rather what I would think expensive essential oil. And lavender, I know that lavender is super popular, and people consider it a basic essential oil. And I simply just don't like it. Like, I don't smell. I don't like the scent of lavender. I finally found one I like, and that's Bulgarian lavender from Avat. I'm going to link below if you guys want to check them out. And then patchouli. I don't like patchouli. I feel like, I know that patchouli kind of has a reputation of being hippie. I see people describing it as a dirty hippie scent. I don't like it. It's just too grounding and too earthy for me. However, I still did purchase this. It was on sale at my local store, and I just decided to get it. And I figured, you know, maybe with a combination of the other essential oils, I would like it. So what they have on the back, the Tranquil Chamomile, what they say is it creates an at-home spa treatment. You're going to sensitize the senses, relaxes the body, and calms the spirit. It has 100% pure essential oils. So in addition to the ones that I've talked about, the Roman chamomile, the lavender, and the patchouli, and I'm not sure what lavender exactly it is, but they have balsam fir. So they've got a fir in here, a conifer, palmarosa, which I like palmarosa. I personally think it smells like honey. My daughter says it smells like Coca-Cola, so that just goes to show you how different and personal scent is. And it also has geranium in it. So those are the essential oils, and those are at the end. Now before that, they have three sodiums listed. They have sodium borate, sodium chloride, and sodium bicarbonate. And sodium bicarbonate is simply baking soda. So I purchased this before I knew what I know now. I feel like every day you're continuing to learn information. So I purchased this, and I took a picture, and I put it in a Facebook group I'm in where there are a number of aromatherapists, certified aromatherapists. And I had a question because I didn't see any emulsifier in here. And what an emulsifier is it helps the essential oil mix with a product, like water. So this is basic elementary school science. If you take water and you put oil, they don't mix together. So an emulsifier helps them mix. So what you have here is you have these sodiums, and these are powders, and then you have the essential oil, which is a liquid. And I didn't see anything in here that would join them together. So I follow what Robert Tisserand says about bath safety, and he has two good posts up about bath safety. I'm going to link to them below. And I put this up in the group because I figured Cacia is a very well known. They've been around for a few decades, like 3 or 4 decades. They should know better than this. And they said that it was not safely formulated. And that kind of gives me pause. So what I did, they say simply dissolve the contents into running bath water, climate, and bliss out, great as a foot soap too. I did not use it like this. I did not follow the instructions. I added this to some shampoo. So shampoo or body wash, it's something that's sudsy, and it can help the essential oils bind together with water. So what you could have a situation is if you simply drop this into water, your essential oils can float to the top, and you can end up with burnt skin. And Robert Tisserand, he gives some examples of a mother, you know, whose children ended up getting burnt skin from essential oils and baths. So you do have to be very careful about it. And I want to show you guys what it looks like. And I'm going to pour it into a bowl so you guys can see. It kind of just, it just looks like powder. It's got no color whatsoever. It kind of smells, it does have a very strong scent. And to be honest, it reminds me somewhat of washing detergent. So what I would wash my clothes with. I don't think it has the best scent. They do say Roman chamomile is supporting and soothing. Lavender is supposed to be relaxing and calming. And patchouli is supposed to be sensualizing and earth connecting. It also is tested and verified for purity. It's cruelty free, no synthetic ingredients, and safe for spas and whirlpools. Despite all this, I don't know if I would repurchase it. I do really have mixed feelings about how this is formulated. I don't believe it's safely formulated based on what I have seen other aromatherapists write about, and I have personally asked aromatherapists, and they don't say it's safely formulated, and I don't really like the scent that much. I just don't like it, the scent that much. It's not formulated to my personal likings. But now I want to hear from you guys. So I gave you guys some information about Aracacia, the company, and I've talked about the product, and also that I have a lot of concerns about the product. So I want to hear from you guys. If you've ever purchased anything from Aracacia, what did you purchase, and what was your opinion of it? And if you haven't, go on over to their website and check them out. They are, you know, they are pretty, I would consider a basic essential oil company. So their oils are pretty affordable. They don't really have exotic things, but they are non-MLMs. And that's something that I really hate MLMs. So it's a very easy company to get involved with. So please leave a comment below. I enjoy reading your comments. Like this video and give it a big thumbs up. Also subscribe to my channel and turn on notifications to get the latest updates. See you guys later.